A couple of you asked me to help out with what I do for waxing and buffing my vehicles so that we get an extra spit shine, you know, as I would call it. So let me walk you quickly through the materials you will need. Okay, this is the wax I use. It's called Zymul. Okay, and you can pronounce it like that, I guess, or Zymul or whatever. You can find it at the auto stores. This bottle has been in my possession now for a couple of years. I don't know if these things go bad, but highly unlikely. But, you know, of course, it comes with directions. Great wax. Okay, fabulous wax. I put a little bit of it here on the lid of a yogurt cup, which I don't throw away. I keep around for these kinds of moments. Okay, then after that, I use the number 2 fine scratch remover, okay, by Novus. It's, you know, it, just like it says, removes fine scratches, and I put a little bit of that on here, okay. Now, these other two products, Novus number 1 is a, it's a cleaner, shiner, and protectant, okay. This is for one of the, you know, next to last stage. All right, and then finally, what I end up using at the very end is Meguiar's Quick Detailer Mist and Wipe. All right, so let me move over you over here, and then I'll walk you through the process. Okay, I'm just gonna do the hood. As you can see, it's already pretty darn shiny. Okay, you're gonna need a piece of a cotton T-shirt. Or a very soft cloth, okay? And this is, of course, a process that you begin after you have done the sanding and buffing cloths, which take you from 3,200 all the way to 12,000, okay? So this is the this is after you do that. As you can see, it's already pretty shiny. Now, this is a process that you could repeat a couple of times. So we're going to start with a wax, okay? Then again, you could use very small pieces. As a matter of fact, I'm going to use this. Just a little piece, okay? And you could wrap it around your finger. Just take a little bit of the wax, all right? And just apply it, okay? You do a panel at a time, just as if you were doing a real car. You do a panel at a time, and you just start, you know, applying it, and you put it down, I guess, until it dries a little bit. Then you can come back and do your next panel. I'm not going to do the whole car. I'm just going to do these two panels so that you could see how it's going. And I also hope all of my hand is not, you know, blocking the view. Okay, so you put that down. All right, now this one should be fairly dry. You know, take your time. I'm just moving quicker here for demonstration purposes. So it's all dried up and it looks a little bit dull. So you take your cloth and then you just, as if you were doing the real car, you know, you buff it and buff it and buff it and buff it until it gets really shiny. I think the more you buff it, the shinier it's going to get. You know, okay, so even though it's pretty shiny, there'll still be some swirl marks that you could see and fine little scratches, all right? So, you know, you keep working it and working it and working it until you're very pleased with the shine, all right? This is a 1962 Impala I've had here for quite a while. This paint has cured very, very, very well. Okay, so that's pretty darn good. All right, so next up, we're going to take you know, another part of our cloth here, and then go with the number two, fine scratch remover, which is this little brown thing, liquid. And again, you know, you're going to put it on there. You make sure that you cover the whole surface. And, you know, try to do it in one direction. But I don't think that's a, you know, that's a basic rule. You just get it on there. Make sure that you get it to cover completely. Same thing with the trunk. Some panels are easier to do than others, and that's fine, you know. So, and here you don't have to wait very long to just come back in and apply a little bit of pressure and buff and shine. And you could, you know, you're going to see it there. It's just getting very, very, very shiny. And it, you know, the reflection is incredible. All right. So then there's a reason why this one comes with a pump spray. You're going to take it and you're going to mist a little bit of it on there. Okay. And again, begin the whole process. And you just, right away, you just buff, applying a little bit of pressure, but, you know, be careful. You don't want to apply so much pressure that you scuff up the paint or, you know, ruin it. Gentle. Notice I'm wearing my wedding band, and it's something I don't recommend you do. If you wear any kind of jewelry or anything like that, remove it. Again, keep your fingernails trimmed. And so basically what you're doing is you're working on the shine. You're getting it closer and closer to that level of perfection. Remember, it's never going to be perfect, okay? I mean, it's as close. Nothing is perfect on this planet, right? It's just as close as you can get it. And it's a good thing to keep in mind all the time, because you want to stave off frustration, right? But, you know, when you get a shine like this, you go, oh, well, you know, that's pretty darn good. Well, you also want to protect your paint job. So this is where Novus One comes in. You spray a little bit of it. Okay. And again, you know, you're going to keep buffing and buffing until you bring the shine back. Okay. Sometimes it's just, it looks dull at first, but the more you buff, you know, the shinier, and look at that. I mean, it looks like you've dipped the part in syrup, okay? And then finally, after you're done, you know, and again, you do this in passes, you take the Meguiar's Quick Detailer. Again, I've had it for a long time, so one of these bottles is going to last you a lifetime, okay? I must have done already hundreds of, not hundreds of models, but at least 50, you know, 100 of them, okay? Same thing. Just a little squirt, all right? You can wear latex gloves if you want, but some latex gloves bring a powdery residue, and you don't want that stuff to get on your paint job or you know, scratch up your paint. So there you have it. I mean, you just keep buffing and spit shining, as I like to call it, until you just get that kind of gloss. I mean, it's just... I don't know if you could see. Yeah, you could see my finger reflecting off of there. All right. So this will protect your paint, and you'll have a painted, beautifully shiny model for a long. It lasts forever and ever. Every couple of years, if you're going to take a model to a show, you can bring it back out and sort of detail it once again by using. Just bring back the detailer. And adding a little bit on a piece of cloth like this, you know, always work with a little piece. Not a big piece, just a little piece will get you through. And that's pretty much it. You know, I've done the body, and you know, the body. I'm very happy with it. But it's one of those things where you practice and you practice and you practice until you get it just right. And like in the real vehicles, you wanna buff and you wanna shine until you just get this beautiful gloss to it. All right, you know, this is important because this one in particular is clear coat safe. And, you know, again, nothing will happen to your model. Just put it away and you'll have a model for years. So apply this, practice, put, you know, start doing this to your paint jobs, and you're going to take your models to the next step. So anyway, let me know if you have any questions. Please subscribe, comment, rate, and generally shine. So let me know what you think. Really appreciate your support and your input. So until next time, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory, and Igor over there saying hello. All right.